Live from Performance Ski and Surf in Orlando, Florida, it's the Murr Show! Starring Sean Murray. On the ones and twos, Eric Ruck. Special guests, Scott Byerly. And George Daniels. And your host, Sean Murray!
Hey, hey, how you doing? I hope this works. This is actually our second take, but you guys don't know that, right? Here we are, live from Performance. We're going to have an awesome show tonight, even though this is our second time doing it. Hey, tonight we've got George Daniels here. Also, we have got none other than Scott, the legend Byerly. I'm excited to have these guys here. I don't know about you guys, but I'm excited about tonight. Not only do we have those guys, but we're here at Performance Ski and Surf. We got Bill Porter, his entire crew hanging out here. We got a live studio audience. We've gone crazy this week. We've moved away from the studio of my house, and here we are. We are having a good time. I don't know if we're up on the internet. I don't know if you guys have a chat box that you can answer questions, or you can ask questions. I don't know if I can answer them, but we're going with this right now. We're getting a little bit later start. It's about 9:15, but hey, that's how we roll. So, let's get right into things. I don't want to drag this on talking about my duck hunting trip over the weekend and stuff like that. But
Murray, basically we're at Performance and we got Scott Byerly and the Goose Man here.
yes sir. Hey, let's have a camera cut to over on Ruck. Okay, there was nothing on him though. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, let's bring up our good friend. He's known as the Goose. Make some internet jibber jabber for none other than George Daniels. All right, George, all right. Let's have a seat. Let's see how we're doing up here.
Oh, yeah. All right.
Okay. Now, I'm not sure if you guys out in the internet land are able to get anything. Oh, goodness. We are chippy choppy. What is going on?
That chippy choppy.
Is it still choppy?
Wow. Oh. That's just like getting kicked in the junk by your computer.
Maybe we should bring Scott up first.
Is this still not working?
Wow. Okay.
Goodness.
Huh. What's going on?
I don't know. I tell you, if I have any more.
Wow. That is... Are we good? He's fine. Are we fine?
Oh, are we good right now?
Well, you know what? Oh, that's probably my wife calling. Maurice. Oh, Maurice answers.
Maurice.
See what Maurice says. Okay, here's what's going to happen, George.
All right.
We're going to roll through this thing, and we're going to see how it goes. George, this is my kitchen timer. I bought it at Target. We're going to set this thing for 15 minutes.
Target's a very nice place.
When this thing rings, we're going to move on, okay?
All right.
So right now, let's begin. Once Bill starts seeing some questions, do you have anything coming in? All right, we don't have questions coming in. So this is going to studio stuff right now, and that's fine.
I'm not mad.
George.
Yes.
You got a bit of a start in skateboarding.
Right.
Let's talk about that. Go.
Well, when I was younger, played a bunch of basketball, skateboarded, and then broke my wrist skateboarding. And met my buddy Philip Asino going into high school, and he wakeboarded. So I tried to wakeboard, didn't really feel comfortable with it. And then he had a wake skate, so I started wake skating.
Okay. Okay.
And you know, skateboarding, wake skating.
I see the transition.
There's a crossover there, Murr.
Makes sense.
Huge crossover.
It makes sense.
Hey, it was fun.
All right. Well, tell me, do you still skateboard? A little bit?
Yeah.
Okay.
Bill actually hooks it up with skate decks here.
Nice.
Keeps me rolling fresh.
Do you ever skate Vans? The skate park?
Yeah.
My brother works there.
Really?
Yeah. My brother Paul.
Paul Murray.
He kind of looks like me more than anything. He sounds like me. So if you hear somebody that sounds like me at Vans, he's my brother. You can go check him out. Tell him I said what's up. So let's talk a little bit about skating right now. The deck that you're wake skating on.
Oh, here it is.
Weird.
Right here. I can't believe it.
Weird.
Well, this is we have the 42 Revival.
Okay.
As everyone can see. But I'm actually riding the 39 right now.
All right, all right. Hey, speaking of wake skating. Speaking of wake skating, in walks none other than Brian Grubb.
Brian Grubb.
We'll have to say hi to him here in a little bit. All right, Grubster. Hey, how are we doing? How are we doing in the internet land? Did Mo say that we have chat box up or anything?
Nothing.
That is crazy.
Gosh.
How was our? What did Mo say about our feed and everything?
Video audio is good.
All right. Well, internet land, you guys are getting shut down tonight, and it's not because of anything we're doing.
Yeah.
But we're gonna continue asking questions. And if you want to call Performance Ski and Surf, the number is 407-859-7544. That's SKII. 859-SKI-E. 407-859-7544. You guys can call in with some questions. I don't know if you guys have a cordless here. If we could get a cordless up here, that'd be great. Do you have a cordless? No cordless. And the phone is ringing. Okay.
Oh, prank callers. You prank callers out there.
You guys can ask questions.
Don't be scared. Hey, we'll have Scott Byerly answer the phone for you.
Hey, what you can do. Hey, Grubb, can you come here and grab this and bring this this microphone to Danny? And then they could put this to the... Grubb, say hi to everybody. What are we on, camera
Brian
one?
Grubb, everyone!
Are we on camera one? There's Trevor's cam, camera one. What's up, Grubb?
Good to have you. Good to have you.
That's what happens. Your performance cancer, people just drop in. All right. So what we'll do, 407-859-7544. This is the first time we've opened up the phone lines on the Murr Show.
Toll free.
Toll free.
Not really, but...
hey,
well, if you're local. If you're local, it's toll free.
Right. But everybody's got a cell phone nowadays, so... Okay. Hey, George, did you know that when you're dialing long distance on a cell phone, you don't need to put one in front of the number?
I don't know.
You don't have to. Okay.
Really?
Okay, so, George, what?
Is that why, like, when I do, like, 1-800 calls, it doesn't work sometimes?
You don't need to put a one before the number on cell phones. Okay.
That's awesome.
So, hey, George.
Yeah.
Oh, we're online. You want to hear a joke?
Let's do it.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Oh, I love this one, I think.
Knock, knock.
Yep. Who's there? Sorry.
Kalp.
Kalp who? yo, dog.
Oh, busted. Dog. Every show.
Bark like a dog.
Bing, bang. All right. Hey, everybody in the internet land, here's how you can get the chat box up. Refresh your page. Recycle little logo. Beep, doop, doop, doop. Hit that thing. You'll have a chat box up. We're going to take this thing into the year 2009.
Refresh your page.
And you can also check out, we are the featured show on Ustream, for real?
Yeah, for real.
Wow. We're on the front page of Ustream.
Gosh, oh, I'm getting nervous now.
That's what we're on, dude.
Oh.
Yo, dog.
All right. Man, that's big time. Hey, you streamers. We're a couple of wakeboarders being goofy here. Actually, some wake skaters here amongst us.
Yes.
George, let's just talk a little bit about some things that happened. Let's talk this year. Highlights of this year. When I say, man, what was the best day you had this year? First thing that comes to your mind is?
Having a baby.
You had a baby? You look great, man.
Oh, thanks, young dog.
You look great.
Thanks, you know how it's being Father of the Year.
I'm Father of the Year? No way.
You just got it, man.
All right, right on. Feels great. It's a great achievement.
Nice. So tell me about your newborn.
He's great. It's a little boy. Name's Jagger, and he's about 9 months old now.
Nice.
So, yeah, it's pretty wild.
That's awesome. Well, congratulations.
His name's Jagger?
Like Mick Jagger.
I was going to say, you could call him Mick for short.
Ah, yeah.
Bing, bang. Hey.
Bada bing.
George, what kind of flip tricks?
Man, I'm just trying to try to get a bunch of them back. You know, I'm a year out of knee surgery right now, and just having trouble, but they're coming.
All right, what kind of knee operation did you have?
I had my ACL replaced again and meniscus.
Same knee.
Ugh. Yeah.
So. That's a drag, bro.
Yeah,
how'd you do it?
I actually did it in Canada at Wake Stock and just trying to shove it out of the pool gap, and it was a big pool gap, and I felt my knee do the kung-kung.
Oh, that's not fun.
And instantly I knew it, and I was just like,
ah. Isn't that a bummer when you have a knee injury? Like, as soon as it goes, you know, like, all right, for the next 6 months, I know what I'm going to do.
Yeah, long road to getting it back, so all that's right, what it's been
right.
for me.
All right. Tell me, if you could have a taco right now.
Oh, I got it. A taco cheesy gordita crunch.
From Taco Bell.
Yeah, dude, that is the bomb.
That's awesome.
Hey, Sean, they're asking, do you prefer cheese?
Do I prefer cheese? I for sure, yeah.
What cheese do you like?
Sharp cheddar all the way.
And a question for Eric. Kids in your future?
Kids in my future.
Married guy?
Far into my future.
Oh, far. Yeah. Let's take a moment to say congratulations. Everybody give
Thank
Eric
you.
Ruck a round of applause. Just got married.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
And also like
Appreciate
to tell
it.
You that you're going to be having people for at least 2 years say, how's married life? At least 2 years. So
yeah, it happens a lot already.
Yeah, it's going to happen for a while.
It's a huge commitment.
All right. Yes, sir. So we got any questions in internet land?
Yes, we do, Sean. It says, want to know what you think of the Lake Murray wake scene in South Carolina.
Oh, Lake Murray Rough Riders. Woot, woot. Those guys
have
been going up there for quite some time. George, if you can ever make it up to Lake Murray, South Carolina, it's a good time.
Okay. I think I've actually been to South Carolina before.
Really?
Yeah.
Sean, another question they asked.
For a week.
When did you purchase a Murriott?
The Murriott was a house that I bought back in 1998, so it's been 11 years now.
And how many people, pro riders, have lived in it?
Oh, man, a number that escapes me right now. But Shannon Best, Kobe Mikosic, Andy Lazarus, Lynn Teachworth, Andrew Atkinson, Shannon Best, did I say that? They escaped. Jerry Nunn, how could I forget that? Thank you, Scott. Jerry Nunn, Christy Nunn.
G Nunny.
A lot of people. So that's the reason that my house has been called the Murriott. But you know something I named my boat? Can you guess what it's called? It's called the Murray Yacht. Get it?
Didn't you just say that?
No. Murriott. Like Marriott.
Okay,
Murray Yacht.
All right. We've got one for George. What was it like filming Push Process? And Moto says you absolutely killed it.
Thank you. It felt pretty cool, you know. Again, with that one, I just came off of a knee surgery as well. So it was kind of hard, but kept it going. And
Do we have a copy of Push Process? Here at Performance Ski and Surf, they have a huge library of videos.
I see it right there.
And I don't know if we keep pulling favors here. Can we pop in George Daniels' section of Push Process?
This house is your house. Anything you want.
It's
your Santa Claus.
I feel comfortable in this house.
Mi shop es su shop. What are the copyright rights? Are we going to get in trouble from Oakley if we play this thing on the internet right now? No.
Of course not.
No.
We're doing
not
promotion.
A problem.
Is there copyrights for you streaming things?
I don't know. I'm not sure. But what we're going to do is once we get to the end of this, we have 4 minutes. I'm telling you, that goes fast, right?
Oh, man. Can I get you like 10?
Yeah, what are you going to do?
Get 10 more?
Yeah. When Scott comes up, you're just going to scoot over. And you're still hanging with us, bro.
Oh, yes.
It's like a real talk show. It's like,
boy.
Like Eric said, it's like Conan.
Conan.
Hey, we just got a quick mention from the newest theme park for Orlando, Cookie Town.
Cookie Town
East is on the chat, and they're wanting to say congratulations on a remote MRR show.
Hey, thanks, Cookie
Town. Thank you, Cookie Town.
All right.
And if you're looking for a Harley, Eastside Harley in Washington, it's the only place in Washington to buy Harley, and they'll probably ship it, too.
Sweet. And that's the voice of Bill Porter right there,
yeah,
everyone.
If you guys ever hear that guy chiming in, that is the voice of the owner, Willie P. Yeah, that's funny. Will he pee? Get it? His name's Bill, and we call him Will. And
will
sometimes
he
call him
pee?
Will, Willie, and his last name's Porter, and pee. Will he pee?
Shameless plug. Sorry. My wife is asking, will anybody please buy our house?
Yes. Hey, okay, once George Daniels is going to do a quick commercial. Can we get a tight shot on this? This is a listing that my dad, Lloyd Murray, is doing for Bill Porter, so check it out. 504 Shannon Road. It's a pretty tight house.
www.lakepinelock.com. Boat lift, boat's not included, but we can talk.
Good old there Pine Lock. Talk. Grubby used to live on Pine Lock.
Yeah, he did.
Cool.
Yeah, dog.
Well, like, we'll be bringing this up throughout the show. We're going to sell this house. They actually said no matter what price anybody offers, they're going to sell it tonight. I'm just kidding. Kidding, Sarah. Ooh. Okay. Some questions for George. We have anything coming up from the web? Any questions for George?
I'm ready. Hit me.
I got a question.
Yes.
What's that?
George.
Ruck.
Nowadays, with, you know, the progression of everything, what really still excites you about wake skating?
Good. It's good.
I think when it's nice and glassy.
That's butter. He likes to shred butter his way.
You know,
yeah, nailed
I'm just
it.
So you know, I'm just so picky with riding. Like I like to ride in a bunch of butter, and that's what excites me the bunch. You know, because you feel confident with all your tricks.
Hey, George, they're asking, did you get to pick the Allman Brothers song in Push Process?
Love that tune.
Yep. Yeah, that was a good one.
Yes. Are we queued up? Okay, we're going to wait a couple more minutes. George, if you could go out tomorrow and land a trick that you've really wanted to land, it would be a...
Backside flip wake to wake?
Backside flip wake to wake.
Maybe. One day, hopefully.
Hey, George, real quick. Greg Allman just came online and wanted to give you big props for using the song in Push Process.
Appreciate it, Greg. Thanks.
Nice, man.
Greg Allman.
All right.
That's cool, man.
And Fidel Castro.
All right.
Fidel.
Hey,
I'm popular.
Hey, give a shout out to my wife, Carrie. What's up, babe? Oh, all right. Hey, we're getting ready to, we've got another minute and a half here.
This coffee's a little stiff.
It is. If we have any more questions for George. George, also, I'd like to know.
Yeah.
What? Well, yes. We do actually have
one.
Yeah,
go ahead.
What kind of lock-in tricks are you working on?
Pretty much I've just been doing, like, trying to, like, blunt slides and stuff a bunch. I haven't really messed with the lock-ins in a little bit, but every time I do, I just try to do blunt slides.
Wood or compression?
Well, right now I'm on compression, but I really do prefer wood. You know, it's got more snappiness to it.
Bi-level?
No bi-level for me. I can't do that.
I gotta say, I'm a fan of riding a wood wake skate myself.
Yeah, you are. I actually seen some footage of you. Was it in Grubbs firsthand? Yeah.
No, it was in rewritten.
Yeah.
Hey, real quick, Dano the Mano checking in.
Hey,
Dano.
Hey.
Oh, you know what that means.
Scott
Bailey.
Hey, what we're going to do right now is we're going to cut over to our video segment of George Daniels.
Hope you guys enjoy.
While we get ready to rock into our next section of the evening. There's Dano's music as we get ready to rock into this. We've got at least 30 minutes left. And whenever you guys are ready, here's a little bit of Push Process coming at you.
Here it is.
Yeep.
Is it going?
Is the audio going?
All right, perfect. That slow-mo is working really good right there. Little heli shot. That's actually out in Claremont riding with James Balzer. Oh, perfect. Well, if you guys can hear me.
Not
They Colvin.
Okay, okay. Hit me with some beats, Ruck.
There we go.
All right. We're back.
And we're live.
Check it out. That was George Daniels, Push Process. Nice wigs, kid.
Thank you, sir.
That was great. Okay. We got a big moment here. We are at Performance Ski and Surf. I've been coming into the shop for years. I remember I worked down the street, actually out in the boonies, at the Benzel Ski Center. I worked at the Benzel Ski Center and I got a sticker that said Team Performance Ski and Surf. And I got like a 15% discount or something. It was awesome. I was like, check it out, team. Still on the team. Love this place. Come by and check it out. 407-859-7544. Where are you guys? We're opening the phone lines. That's the number to the shop. Call us. Love to chat. Check it out. 407-859-7544. And while you guys are figuring out where your phones are, I'm going to bring up probably the most special guest we're ever going to have on the show. Because this guy is a guy who brought our sport into a new direction. This guy, as I said in the Parks documentary, can open a can of soda and look cool doing it. It's pretty good. Ladies and gentlemen, make a lot of noise for none other than Mr. Scott Byerly.
It's good.
Thank you. All right. Here we are. This is happening. Do we have chat? We have questions coming up and stuff. All right. Look out, Scott. They're going to start flying in.
Oh, no.
Anybody like to say hi real quick before we get started here with the official timer?
Oh, no. My cup of Joe.
Uh-oh. Gosh. Yeah, it's going to smell like coffee in here for a while. Uh-oh. Bill's laughing, but he's crying inside. Okay.
Can we maybe get some napkins? We got coffee all over
can't
the place.
Take this anyway.
I know. That's why we can't have nice things, George.
I mean, we're on a dock. We're on a dock.
I know. Sitting on the boat dock like Jerry Nunn. Okay, Scott.
Hey, Rock,
you got that. You got that.
Do you know that one?
Never throw in tantrums.
Play it.
Play it.
I wish I knew that one, but that's one I don't know.
We're going to have to learn
I've got
it. We're going to learn.
That's a must.
Johnny's
a must
Wakeboard
for sure.
Clinic.
It's probably pretty easy, Rock.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Some good history behind that one. Wow. How many total hours? People in internet land, how many total hours in a tat chair, Scott?
I do not know.
Estimated.
Lost count.
Like seven?
Yeah, I'm
going to
go refill my cup of Joe real quick.
I don't know.
What's going to happen if
Wakeboard has to take one, Scott's
daughter? Uh-oh. Uh-oh. That's already happened. I have a 16-year-old, and she was dating one of my friend's kids, and he wake skates, so...
That's awesome, Sarah. Good questions. Right on, right on. Hey, well, Scott.
Murray.
I grew up watching you, and I mean, not really. I mean, I was like on your heels, like watching the '94 World Championships in Isla Morada, and you and Gator were there. Tell me just a little bit about what it was like. Were you guys training a lot together? I don't want to say training. That's lame. That's lame. I apologize. Were you guys riding a lot together, you and Gator at that point? Like working hard? You're like, we're going to go and we're going to win this thing.
Yeah, we just always rode together and, I don't know, it just happened.
Yeah. That was awesome. And I remember one of the coolest ads was the 69 thing that you guys did. Remember
love that? That one. I had that one on my wall for a long time.
Who shot that? Tom King? Nice.
Is this one of them? Like that?
Yep.
That was it.
That was it.
I haven't been in a while. I was just saying we needed to go to Grub. I think it was today. We need to go ride.
Did it the last time we go? Like, we were all there, right? Last time?
I'm talking about Vans right now.
I saw your brother there.
Yeah. My brother Paul said he sees you at Vans skating.
Is he older?
Younger.
Younger?
Yeah. Normally has kind of a beardish
beard
face.
Is he taller?
No, he's just a little thicker than me. Like, he's stronger.
Do you play circus music for Murray on the show?
Sometimes.
I try. I have theme music for Dano that I play. I don't have actual theme music for Murray, except for the Murr Show blues tune. But, you know, it's constantly evolving.
Little circus.
Scott's always referred to me as Circus Boy.
Like that.
What's the coolest thing Scott Byron has ever seen?
What is the coolest thing Scott Byerly has ever seen regarding
that? That is a great question.
That's great. Hey, you have a lot of years. You have a lot of years to look back on, Scott. Like, you know, what has stuck out in your mind?
The greatest thing ever in wakeboarding?
No, that you personally have seen. What are you like, wow, that was pretty bad.
That, you know...
As in Michael Jackson bad.
Something
like
that
bad.
You didn't
J.D. Webb,
do.
Yeah.
J.D. Webb jumping over the fountain.
That was pretty insane.
That was a pretty insane day. Yep.
Time stopped.
It certainly did.
I was there. I was in a boat.
I was in the boat, too.
You were driving him.
Yeah. I drove him. It was pretty intense.
How fast was he going?
28. Oh, Scott, you got to talk right into that thing.
Hey.
Hey. Okay.
J.D. Webb.
Here's a J.D. Webb jumping the fountain, all-time moment. I'd say that was pretty cool.
That was.
I'm gonna reminisce just for a moment. I'm going to go to the May Day days. Some of you guys know what I'm talking about. And coolest moment for me on the trip, we all went out to Lake Powell. I was a little bit of an oddball in the bunch, kind of like I still am these days, but that's cool. But I went out there, and Randy Harris went out and rode. Everybody's on the houseboat, and I thought, I'm gonna go take a ride. And so I went and I did some double ups right in front of the houseboat. We're filming.
I feel like I'm in the video right now.
Yeah, totally. And I did a seven. And everybody was kind of packing up their bags. Somebody's phone is giving us a lot of sound. That's okay.
Sounds like it's passed.
So everybody was kind of packing up stuff. I was packing up his board and like finished. And then I landed the seven. And then Scott grabs his board out, and I was like, that is awesome. And then Scott goes out and lands the sickest toe side seven off the double up, and I was like, that was awesome. That just happened. You remember that?
It was a long time ago.
That was awesome.
Long time ago.
That was awesome.
You got a good memory.
Thanks. Remember that one time? When John McDougal got mad at us because we were shooting firecrackers back of the boat and he came and beat up Chase? Yeah.
Sorry.
That was awesome.
Yeah, I remember.
That was awesome.
Where's John McDougal?
I don't know. I haven't seen that guy in a long time. People in internet land, you're going to answer the question.
Wow.
From when you first decide to start a board, how long does it take start to finish?
That would be a Scott Bouchard question. He has lots of hours shaping those boards out in Melbourne. So, I mean.
But let's say, okay, it's
it takes
December. How long until you're done?
3 months or something, probably. 3 months.
Yeah, it depends on the shape, your success with the shapes. Sometimes you can be done with it in a month.
Yeah,
sometimes
you never know.
Sometimes it'll take a year. Yeah,
I'm loud now.
It's a trial and error process.
And how involved are you in the shaping process? I know the answer. I'm just asking.
Butch shapes the boards and we ride them, so we're involved.
Sorry. that was a buzz. That's what it says. On that button. Sorry.
Ruck, do you have a buzz?
The Parks Laugh. The Parks Laugh. I got to even... I got to get into the moment. Hold on. Just give me a minute. Talk for a second.
I got a question for Scott.
Talk for a second, Scott.
Okay. Shoot. Scott, what from the beginning, from like... watching the sport of wakeboarding evolve, what would you say do you think was the most exciting time in wakeboarding so far?
When we first started, it was just fresh and it was just
who is
just
front?
Went with it and just had fun and just started landing new stuff that nobody's ever done before, so. Back in the beginning, Ruck.
Mm-hmm.
The
beginning. That's what I was hoping to hear.
They want to know why you never wore gloves.
Yeah, Scott, why don't you ever wear gloves, man? I wear gloves. They're cool. It's cool.
I never had a pair.
I'll loan you mine next time. Hey, original crew that you rode with, when it first comes to your head, you're like the days you'd ride with Eric Gator. Who else is with your gang?
Back in those days was Rich Goforth, Brandon Meek, Eric Luckert,
McCrassen.
Greg McCrassen.
Mm-hmm.
My brother.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Yeah,
I've seen your brother in a long time.
He's still riding. He's out in Mexico right now.
Is he really?
Teaching wakeboarding.
Yeah. Nice.
He's doing it big.
Oh, man, I should have said, check out Stoke Me. You should text him. Well, that cost money to send it to Mexico. Okay. Bill, question. Ooh.
Ooh.
Better style, Schmaltz or Nelson?
I bet that was, I don't know.
That's a tough question.
That's tough. That's two different areas.
Yeah. How
about this one? Whatever happened to your old Bayliner? Whoa, someone knows you.
I never
good.
Had a Bayliner.
I know what he's talking about. He's talking about in spray when you said, yeah, you'd say, I'll take a Bayliner.
I'd take a Bayliner. I've ridden behind some Bayliners, but I've never had one.
You know what I wish we had? I just saw somebody posted a video of you ripping behind a barefoot Mastercraft, I think it was.
I saw that.
Dude, it was crazy, everything you were doing.
Tripping. Straight waking?
Straight waking.
Straight waking.
Just pulling off mobs and big old fronts, toe side crips. There was basically no wake behind this thing.
I saw that.
It was pretty
crazy.
It was nuts. And you went for a long time. I was impressed. I was like, you go, Scott. That's what I was like. Yeah. I didn't say that. That would have been weird, but I just said it. It's super weird. Hey.
We just got notes from Corey at Hyperlight Firely. They're going to be giving away Firely hats tomorrow in honor of these guys coming on the show on Facebook.
Awesome. What's up, Corey?
Free stuff.
That is awesome. Corey at Hyperlight, tomorrow, go to Hyperlight's Facebook page, and they're giving away Byerly hats in honor of these guys coming to Performance Ski and Surf and being on the Murr Show. That is right. Hey, Scott, I just heard, and I know I sound like I'm getting excited now. It's because I am. I just heard that you got back on a wakeboard?
I heard that too.
I've pulled them.
Yeah. That's awesome. How cool is that though, right?
It's sick, man. He actually just moved out the Windermere, and he's out there on the Butler chain. And the other day we're out there, he's hitting docks, man, like old school.
Please tell me you're doing sick toe fronts.
Fun stuff.
Saw one of those.
Did you do a toe front?
2 weeks ago. Yeah.
Oh man, I'd pay money to do one of those. Like you know, this toe front. Man, it's awesome.
It's
half cab front.
It's fun. You know, just having fun doing just old stuff.
I tell you,
the lakes are sick out there, and we just go forever, and
yeah,
it's pretty fun.
Endless lines out.
Fun.
I'm excited to hear that because I was just talking to somebody.
Never
this
actually
year.
Wore closed toe bindings before, and they're amazing.
That's pretty good, huh?
Yeah.
Them are good.
A lot different.
People who are like, why do you want closed toe? Why would you want closed toe?
Who invented that?
You know? The Sub Rosas. Actually, Dick Pope Jr. designed some, I think, on his Cypress Garden.
Brandon Meek had some shoes hooked to some bindings one time. They were closed toe.
There you go.
That's Brandon true.
Yeah.
I believe that.
B1.
Hey, but like I was saying, I'm pretty excited to see you ride, Scott, and maybe see some photos. I heard some pics have been taken.
Yeah, we took a couple pictures, and yeah, I'm going to ride it. It's fun.
That's cool,
man. I'm having
fun.
Just having fun with it.
Nice.
Still wake skating a lot with these guys. BT, Grub, George.
A little crew.
Ross Gardner.
Nice.
It's fun.
Nice.
Having fun with it.
That's tight, though, because, like, when you guys are all riding, like, you got guys like Ross who wake skate and wakeboard, so now you can, like, if he's all like, hey, I'm kind of bored because everyone's wake skating, I feel like wakeboarding, now you can be like, hey, Ross, I'll take a shred with you.
Yeah, I'll take a shred.
Ross rips.
Definitely.
He flies.
Yeah.
He likes to
Yeah. And he works at the other bar. I saw him there the other night at the grand opening.
Ryan Davis just opened it up.
The other bar.
Yeah.
And BT actually DJ'd that one, I heard.
Nice.
Drop top. So if you guys have any Christmas parties.
Speaking of shindigs, okay, Scott is known to host a Halloween party. How long ago did that start?
Man, it's been probably 7 years now.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Was it? When was the first one? Because I met you in 2004.
The first one was that upstairs place, right?
In Winter Park?
In Winter Park, yeah.
Yeah.
Winter
Park.
Oh, yeah.
That's when I first met Scott.
What was your favorite costume from that soiree this year, George? What was your
this
favorite
year?
Costume?
I'd say Spencer Williams.
What was he
this year?
Best?
He was OxyClean in honor
of Billy Mays.
Oh, wow.
If you want OxyClean, it works on everything.
That is great.
That's what he sounded like.
Yeah, he was full on in character. Wow. Not out of character. I think
Spence loves Halloween.
Yeah, he's actually had like the best costumes the past couple
he's
years.
He's won
now.
Every year, Murray.
Really? So was he in your opinion the fave?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
He played the part.
Nice.
He played the part.
Couple questions. Ooh, talk about Toe Jam.
I don't know if Rathy's going to wake skate in it, but it'd be great if he did, you know.
Toe Jam.
I think we're still working on it. I can't give out any details on it right now.
All right, that's enough.
Is that it?
Yeah, really?
That's the laugh?
Oh, man.
I haven't in a while.
What will it take for you to ride a rail jam?
A really good setup.
Really good setup.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's all about
something
setup.
That has a long takeoff.
Mm-hmm.
And a landing.
And a landing.
And something to stop
and
it.
A deep and some landing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have
a guy named Painter Monkey that must be painting your house wanting to borrow your motorized skateboard. Painter Monkey wants to borrow your motorized skateboard?
It's not the pool guy.
That's his name.
Is that your brother?
Painter Monkey?
Hey, let's talk just really quick before.
Oh! Oh, no.
Okay.
Rewind it.
Okay, we're going to give 2 minutes to talk about Byerly wakeboards. I mean, this has been something that I know was in the works for many years. and something that when you first came onto Hyperlite, they're like, yeah, let's get this started, kind of got pushed back. Now that it's going, tell me your thoughts on it. I think it's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's great. We picked up some really good riders.
Yeah,
Aaron
obviously.
Aaron Rathy, Mitch Langfield, they both won the world championships this year.
That's a good way to do it.
Sorry.
Speak it up.
It's great working with Butch and, you know, everybody over at Hyperlite. They've, you know, given me the opportunity to do Byerly boards. Just coming out with new shapes and wake surfers and new boots, everything. It's really cool.
Every year it gets bigger.
Yeah, we doubled our line this year, and like I said, we got the best riders, in my opinion, for sure.
Thank you.
Yeah, not
and the best shaper, you know, Butch is just always shaping new stuff and has so many ideas, and it's great.
Cool, man.
It's also really cool to be a part of a team that, you know, you're the boss, pretty much, like you ride with every day, and like, you know, that's something cool, you know, with me.
Yeah.
So I really like being a part of the Byerly Boards. If anybody out there wants to know.
No, I do think it's pretty cool the way that you guys have it designed from yourself to Butch and the team that you have. Pretty solid stuff. You guys can check it out, Byerly Boards.
They want to know, living in Windermere, is it required for your wife to carry a golf club?
Oh, living in Windermere.
Oh, I want to tell that joke I told the other day, but okay. I can't really tell it that good.
You can try, George. It's okay.
I hope she doesn't have a golf club.
Well, I heard this joke. It was like...
She might hit me with my wake skate.
Like, the guys on the PGA Tour were wondering what golf club she used because they've been wondering, like, how to beat him. Or, like, you know, you kind of get it.
You got to tell the joke. Right?
I can't really tell it, though. Like, I kind of forgot. Like, they're wondering club he used to beat him.
You heard Tiger change his name today.
What's that?
He changed it to the Cheetah.
I get it. Cheetah. Hey, do you think
he's the cheetah now?
Do you think that his wife called his caddy to find out what club she should use? That's mine.
Ah.
That's all me.
Ooh.
Oh. A knock knock joke. Hey, Scott, I don't know if you were paying attention earlier. Knock knock.
I wasn't paying attention earlier. Who's there?
Cowp.
Cow poo.
Cow poo.
I get it.
Cow poo. You can tell it to your girls later.
I will.
This is pretty awesome. Scott has four girls.
Three.
Four. You're married.
Yeah, Kim's, four with Kim.
Yeah, four girls. I've got two girls, one on the way. I got Carrie, my wife, my little girl Hayden, and then I got girl to be named. That's the hardest part of the whole process. Is that hard for you guys? Name you got your kids got cool names, and we can't use any of them. I won't do that, but I thought about it. Using your kid? No, I'm not gonna do that. But tell me really quickly about your girls.
They're great. It's never a dull moment at the house, for sure.
Mm-hmm.
I'm definitely outnumbered, and just wait.
I know. That's what I'm thinking. I'm like, you know so many things that I have yet to learn.
Yeah, just wait.
All right.
Hasn't even started yet for you.
Oh, man. Here we go. Hey, well, I tell you what. Let's cut to, do we have May Day up? We have got a video from 1998.
Wow.
Yeah.
10 years. Decade.
11. But who's counting?
Hey.
So this is a movie. It's called Mayday. The reason it's called Mayday?
Fall Line Films.
Is the bummer was, remember when we went out and we had the Mayday call from those people and they were stranded on their houseboat?
I remember.
They lost all the footage from it. And so the reason for the movie is called Mayday is because people called Mayday to our houseboat while we were on the trip. Bummer they lost the footage. But anyway, we're cutting here to Scott Byerly's part in just a minute. And you guys check out the movie Mayday. If you want to see this, you can get it on, I'll tell you about it after you watch it, because you're going to want to get it. This is kind of a must-have DVD collection.
This coffee's great, Murray.
It is.
Did you brew it yourself?
No, Ruck did.
Oh.
Ruck brewed.
Oh, that's
yeah,
great.
Organically brewed at my place.
All right.
Do both those cameras work?
Yeah. Yeah, man.
I mean,
like, those are actually just props, George. Just props.
Well, no, you know, wow. I don't know. I mean, like, which one's actually focusing on us? Because I want to look at both.
The right one?
That one. All right.
Yeah, we don't have the red light to tell you which one to look at. We just have a guy that points.
Yeah.
Trevor just points.
All right, there it is. There we are.
All right. Aaron, take it away. The movie Mayday.
I looked up to Scott because he's really stylish, invents all the new tricks, and then we try to imitate him. Probably that's who everyone tries to be like a little, you know, just because he's Scott. You know, he's rad, cool guy, fun to hang around.
Blast from the past.
Are we on? All right, we are back. What'd you guys think of that, huh? Scott Byerly. That is why he's a good wakeboarder, because he can do that stuff. So, before we kind of move on to our next segment, we're going to have a quick intermission because, like I said, when you're here performing ski and surf, we have people stop by. Parks might stop by, JD might walk in, or, ladies and gentlemen, coming in from the west side, Mr. Brian Grubb!
Hey! Grubb style!
All right, Grubber. Grubb, there's a mic, maybe George?
I have it.
Okay.
Here. there.
Well, we can kind of round table. Maybe next year when budget gets kicked up, we can get another mic.
Budget.
Or guest. But, Greb, like I said, we're going to have you on for a full show. But if you guys want to send in a couple questions. Okay. If you guys want to send in a couple questions to Greb. Just on here, just for some quick questions, there'll be a little teaser for the next segment when we bring in Greb for a whole murr show.
What was it like working
at
Performance?
Oh, there's
That's
a good
question.
Oh, good question.
Long time ago.
What was it like working at Performance Ski and Surf?
Working here at Performance was great. I mean, I started working here like right after I turned 16, and it's always where I wanted to work, and it was awesome. I got to meet Scott and all the pro guys like that I looked up to like when I was working here and stuff, and got to fix all their boots for them. and it was awesome.
Now,
so.
Remind me, the first video I saw you were actually wakeboarding. Was that Hype? Dose or something? Or?
Daily Dose was the
Daily
first
Dose.
One.
And I was like, this kid's good. Were you boosting off the big kicker at Nick and Jules, or was that on your
that
wake
was
skate?
That was in Hype, I think.
That was in Hype on your wake skate, right?
Yeah. Dose was down at Nick and or at Dean's house.
Yes.
We shot down there for a couple days.
Yes. Remember, Staker was in Daily Dose.
Yeah, he was. That was shot at my house. That was awesome.
Yeah, he rode for Hype probably for like a month.
You know what we forgot to do? We forgot to say, hey, that video. That video you guys saw is called Mayday by Fall Line Films. Name the guys from Fall Line Films.
Artie.
The One Man Party.
And Jerry.
Jerry Dugan.
What about Reed?
And Reed. Yeah.
Good call.
Yeah, good guys from back in the day. So check this out. If you guys want to get that DVD, it's called Mayday, but you can get it in a 3-box set. Mayday, Spray, and Hit It.
Oh yeah.
Some good solid movies. Good history to
I'd have to say that really when it comes down to it, I'd have to say that Hit It might possibly be my all-time. Hit It or Spray is my all-time
fave.
I mean, when I think about what changed my mind to really want to be able, or you know, be a wakeboarder. Mm-hmm. Those are mind-blowing.
I like Spray.
Oh yeah.
I like Spray.
Yeah,
Spray
is my favorite.
I mean, you can still watch Spray today, and there's things that like back in the day people didn't even really give credit to, but now when you look at it, you're like, mind blowing.
Do you guys remember when like tying low was cool? Like you don't tie high. Tying low was cool.
Oh yeah.
That was like the Mayday.
Tying low.
Yeah, like no skylines. Low.
No, well remember the Nautique had that like halfway one, and that's the one that Chase and Thomas and those guys would only ride behind.
Right.
They'd go up halfway.
Yeah, we'll meet you in the middle. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I can't believe I've gone this long. Like, we've got three of the greatest wake skaters in the world right here.
In the world,
Ruck. You know, like, we haven't had this much wake skating talent. I don't think we'll ever have it again. Sitting right next to us, Byerly, who do you have your eye on right now as far as the up and coming talent?
I don't have my eye on anybody, but I would have to say.
Who made you go?
Andrew Pastera's brother. He's really, really good.
Really? Pastera's brother?
Yeah.
Okay.
Chris Callis is ripping.
Chris Callis is good.
He's back from Australia for a couple weeks, so.
Nice.
Oh, yeah. I saw him the other night, and I was like, did you even leave?
Yeah.
He
went
over
back.
Like a month. And
I didn't even know he left, and he's back.
He missed it so much, he had to come back. So.
Nice.
Watch out for him.
Who do you think, George?
Definitely the Pastera brothers, for sure. Like, Andy has a bunch of style. Like, he's really skatey, very technical. And I saw something on New Pollution with his little brother, and he's ripping right now, too. So, at Austin. So, definitely the Pastera family, for sure.
They're saying Aaron Perkins is the next big thing. Ooh, Aaron Perkins. He's actually our tech guy. We get a shot of Aaron here.
That's true.
Check this guy out. You can go see
Working
him.
Working the boards.
Yeah,
park
like a dog.
See him at OWC, and he's one of the operators there. And for years, this kid Aaron has lived in front of me. You guys have like seen him hanging out, and he like would never ride. Yep, and I'm like, hey, come to the cave. He was like, no, I'm gonna go ride my bike. No, I'm gonna play video games. So finally, he decides to go, and now the kid's gotten really good. You guys have seen him; he's doing quite neat tricks.
I've seen him out there.
Mm-hmm.
Seen him at the Toe Jam.
Yeah.
Did really well.
Yes, sir. Talk about the your new Byerly boards for rails and sliders.
Yeah, the Salt. Butchie came up with a real bulletproof rail on it, and pretty indestructible. And you know, the molded in fins are ABS inside there, and you really can't grind them down. So it's a really, really good board for rails.
My new board's actually quite nice because of the rounded tone heel edge and the spine down it, so you don't touch too much of the board on the rails. Pretty quick on rails.
And they're asking if Brian still has the record for the largest Indian rope jump on a slalom ski.
Brian, largest Indian line on a slalom ski. Did you do
anyone
that?
Ever tried that since then? I think that happened like once.
I don't know. Did you do it?
A long time ago, yeah.
That's awesome.
I always tried to do flips on slalom skis. I was just trying to do what Parks was doing, but for some reason I was on a ski.
That's cool.
I can't remember why exactly.
I did on combo kitty skis, so it's cool.
Oh, yeah, those are good. Yeah. I remember that.
Uh-huh.
Sean, why I remember we put those.
Yeah, I remember that. Say what? I went three-stage rocker because we were able to do, it's not a flat spot, it's kind of a blended between... a couple different rockers, but
hybrid.
I wanted to go higher, is why.
Some pop.
Yes, I wanted to go higher, but not flat spot. So we were able to do that.
Scott, they're asking about your new shoes. What you got going for free?
Check out these kicks on your feet right now.
Yeah, we worked on a new shoe. It's a, you know, both upper and lower, brand new. So it's a little like a mid top. Really like them. A lot of padding around the ankles and
looks like gray suede.
Come in three Ooh. Colors: gray, black, and
I'm wearing
blue.
I'm wearing some right now.
Yeah.
Hey, Mer,
I'm wearing Byerly's right now.
Wedding.
Yeah, our whole all of the groomsmen and me and my dad and Joy's dad, we all had the
shiny Byerly's,
the crocodile.
Crocs.
The crocodillos.
Crocodile yep. skin Byerly's. Yeah. They look good. I saw them in the pictures.
They look great.
They're
mm-hmm. really good.
Kind of cool. Really cool.
Was that hard to talk Joy into?
No, she was totally into it. She was psyched on it.
Great wedding. Great wedding.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, it was fun. A lot of dancing.
Mm-hmm.
And it was good.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir.
I
heard Brandon Meek fell in the lake.
Brandon Meek was, I mean... in a surprisingly good mood all night long.
Yeah.
He was. He was. We had a lot of good combos. Okay, I'm going to put us at 5 minutes here. And
board graphics.
Let's talk board graphics really quick. What is the best board graphic, your favorite board graphic under the Byerly name since your name's been on one?
Wow.
Yeah, I know.
It's a lot. I just actually took all my boards out of the shed because I moved.
Do you have one of every?
I put them all up on the ceiling in my house. So
do you have?
I've been looking
have them
at them. No, I don't have them all.
Do you have one of the naked broad holding the dude's head?
That's one that I'm missing. Or the heart.
Oh yeah, the heart. Yeah, that's right, the heart.
The chick ripping the heart out. Yeah. I need that one. The Wake Tech, Bat Tail. So if anybody has it out there. I'll trade you something. I'll trade you a new Byerly board. My favorite graphic. Maybe the one, my old Wake Skate, the wood one with me and the kids on it, and the American flag.
Mm-hmm. I like that one.
The silhouettes of Chelsea.
Yeah, where you're
Kira.
Standing there in a silhouette. I like that one. Yeah. I do like that one.
Classy.
Old school.
Kind of awesome, yet hits you right here.
Yeah.
Yeah, like American pride and family pride all in one.
All in one.
America. Very patriotic.
America. What was your first tattoo and when did you get it?
Little tribal band. I hate it. I wish it wasn't.
I didn't mean to hit a sore subject. It's not like I knew the question to ask.
Yeah.
Okay, what was your latest tattoo? What's the latest one you did? You don't have to show it, but you can tell me.
Oh, yeah. Maybe my wedding ring on my finger. A diamond.
Mm-hmm.
I can't lose this one. Well, hopefully I don't.
Yeah.
I lost two wedding rings, so I got it tattooed on my finger.
Might as well, right?
My wife really hates it.
She doesn't like that tattoo?
She hates it.
Really?
Yeah.
That's weird. Okay. Yeah, Bill Porter says he's got a he's got a tattoo.
Doesn't
on his finger.
Shawnee D got one tatted on his
got
finger?
Yep.
And I think the Rustler does too.
Oh yeah.
It's officially cool now. Yeah. Wow. Grub, when
yeah,
you
when
get
are you
a tattoo?
Get a tattoo, Grub?
I have no plans to get one, but maybe someday. You never know.
Yeah.
Hey, Grub.
I heard Tiger Woods is cheating on his wife.
I heard that, too.
Yes. I heard that Charity Merriman is dating Doug Homan.
No.
Yeah, right.
I'm just kidding. Those are just two old school names I just pulled way from the deep. Yeah.
Doug Homan, he used to boot out a back roll if I ever seen him boot it out a back roll.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Yeah, if you know Doug Homan, give me a woot woot.
Woot woot.
All right. Well, if we have any more questions out there, we can do that. Ruck, maybe get some jams going. I feel like we need a little freestyle jam here.
Pick jam up
a little bit. For me to sing.
Sing Copacabana.
Yeah, I don't know the lyrics to Copacabana. You know, I've had a good time here tonight. I don't know if you guys have anything else you'd like to say. Some shameless plugs, sponsors, things you're doing, places you're going. I'm going to the Denver Boat Show. You can see me at the Denver Boat Show, January 15th to the 17th. So come by the Denver Boat Show. I'm going out there for Hyperlight. I'll stop by the Nautique booth. And do we have a shot of this? This is Bill Porter's house. Lakefront for sale, 504 Shannon Road. Go to lakepinelock.com. Go get yourself a house.
I should have made one of those signs for me, too. I got a house for sale.
Well, tell us about it, Scott. We're not afraid to advertise on here.
It's in the UCF area, right on the lake.
And if they want to buy it, they can go to...
Actually,
not a website, but they can talk to, yeah.
And they got you got a good neighbor over there, too. Uncle Tony, right?
Uncle Tony, yeah.
I know Tony. I like Tony. I play hockey with Tony sometimes.
Yeah. Still play on the team?
I haven't played all year.
Why not?
I got kids. Yeah. I'm learning that
Uncle
whole time.
Uncle Tony and Team Ninja Murray.
Yeah. He's a good hockey player. And his wife rides horses like my wife, and they talk horses.
Yeah.
So it's a good thing. Horse talk. George Daniels, I've enjoyed having you on the show tonight. I've really enjoyed having you on the show tonight.
I'm happy to be here, man. I was nervous coming into it, but you know what? Stuck through, had a few, you know, cups of coffee, a little jelly, you know, I'm ready.
Right on. Well, Grub, I am glad you stumbled upon us tonight. I'm glad you came by to say hi.
Thanks for having me.
It's been a great time. What's that? Yeah, we'll do this again. We will definitely come back to performance. Scott Byerly, I have really enjoyed having you on the show as well.
Thanks for having me, Murr.
It's an honor to have you.
Thanks to Bill Porter, too, for letting you...
Oh, of course. Of course. Bill Porter... His whole crew that has helped us out at the shop. You guys, come into the shop. There's so much stuff in here you can kind of barely get around. And now that we've brought our set in here, you can't get around. But I'd like to thank everybody who has made this possible. Maurice, Karch, all the guys out there. Trevor Ward, great having you on the camera and bringing all your expertise. Aaron Perkins, not only can you wake skate, you can operate some computers and some monitors. So thank you, sir. Eric Reck, always enjoy having you.
Jamming.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's a wrap. We would like to see you out here next time. We're first and third Thursdays for the Murr Show. The next one, I believe, is on Christmas Eve, so it's probably not going to happen. Maybe I'll just tune in from Texas, like from my laptop, and say, hey, what's up? But maybe not. We'll see. But ladies and gentlemen, I've had a great time. My name is Sean Murray. I've got all these guys with me. Bill Porter, once again, thank you for having us. We'll see you guys next time.